Hello folks, this is BestInSlot. We're back with a little bit more of our Planet Zoo campaign. We're working on part 2 of the second campaign level, trying to do the gold bits. I've paused it just temporarily. Remember in the last video, Nancy wants us to add 3 more species to our zoo. So the first thing we need to do is A, get the zoo kind of running spick and span, get it running properly, and then also choose, what's going on with the staircase down there? Oh, I like that. And also choose what animals we're going to add as part of it. So, let's have a look. The problems are, at the moment, we have a high amount of litter. I'll tell you what, let's just do that. Let's hire some human people. Any human people? Caretakers is what we need. We're going to stick a few of those in. Really, I should be giving them pass and stuff. I'm just going to chuck them all around the zoo. That'll clear things up, no problem. That should be enough. And that should cure both of those problems. Now, if we hop into zoo and hop into the animal menu, we can check what we have. We have a lesser Antillean iguana. We have the bonobos. We have the Bornean orangutans. We have, again, something I haven't seen before, the giant burrowing cockroach. I kind of want to check this guy out. Where is he? Waynette. Beautiful name. Let's get a good look at Waynette if we can. There she is. I'll tell you what, let's hop into Ansel. Is it? Oh, I pressed the wrong button. Control slows you down. There she is, Waynette, looking terrified. I have a thing. I don't like cockroaches, okay? Let's just put it that way. I'm not a big fan of the cockroaches. But that's okay. Waynette, it's not your fault. Is that an empty exhibit right there? It is. So we're going to stick our first animal right in there when we decide what we want that to be. Of course, we're going to build a proper exhibit as well. So we have bonobos, orangutans, Gila Monster, cockroach, hippos, iguanas, mandrills we haven't actually seen yet, red ruff lemurs, and ring-tailed lemurs. Let's go check on our mandrill exhibits. This one over here. Where are they at? There we go. Again, with the feces worshipping the sun god Ra. Ra's the sun god, right? I'm not going crazy. Ra, Ra, sun god Ra. Right, that's a song. Officially. Wait, what's your buddy? Oh, he's picked up a ball thing. Mandrills, they're just like us. I too have picked up ball things. Wait a minute. Okay, cool. So, let's see, first of all, let's try to fill this exhibit up over somewhere. Where the hell was it? Oh, just a memento. I love that. I don't know why. Where the hell was that exhibit? Was it over here? There it is. So, let's look for anything we don't already have. Oh, we've got loads of options, including ones I've not seen before. Like the giant tiger land snail. That's definitely going to be our choice. It could be that, or it could be the Goliath frog. But I think this lovely little... Oh my god, conservation points for a exhibit animal. That's new. You never used to have that. Let's send our snail in. There we go. Low welfare. I know, my friend. I'm going to get you spick and span. Don't you worry about it. I'm going to give you a big old rock pile. People love big old rock piles. And we're going to knock that humidity right down. We're also going to get a little bit of research on the go. I feel bad for my snail. Who doesn't? You know? Who hasn't felt bad for a snail in their day? There we go. Is that good? Looking good. Feeling good. 90%. Lovely stuff. Going to stick a wall on as well. They look better with the middle window closed. Look at that. First time. Beautiful, and we'll do the same on this one on the right. Nope. It's always the last one you click. Okay, last time it was the first one I clicked, but that's not the point. There we go. I actually changed some of these icons. I think that Windows icon is new. Perfect. Good stuff. So then, what are we going to do for our final habitat? Obviously, this is perfectly set up over here to give us a little something. I'm just going to kill the trees. I kind of want to do my own foliage. I believe options include BAIRD'S TAPIR, which is something I think would be pretty cool to do. We're going to bring in the BAIRD'S. And then I kind of like the idea of doing like a mixed exhibit with the BAIRD'S and a primate. So can we get the BAIRD'S TAPIR to live well with a chimpanzee, for example, without them both going mental? Well, folks, there's only one way to find out. I do want to flatten this island out. I love the trees. The trees look great, but I'd rather do... Can I not just... Is there not a quick way to do this? You guys in a group by any chance? That would make my life easy. No. I'll skip forward, folks. decided I'm going to keep the shape of the island. I think it's quite a cool little shape already. We're going to use that. We're going to try to use the natural environment that the game has given us to build this exhibit. Let's hop into animal trading. So our options to kick things off. It has to be a new species. That's important. We have Baird's Tapir. We have Baird's Tapir. We have Baird's Tapir. I'm sure I saw chimpanzees in here as well. So far we have Baird's Tapir, and that's basically literally it. All the others are animals we already have, so of course they're not going to contribute towards our... Am I going crazy? Alright, let's find ourselves... It's Western, isn't it? Yeah. Huh. Interesting. Okay. I suspect we're going to be getting an Antillean iguana, so we're just going to make a lovely little Baird's Tapir exhibit instead. That's totally what I wanted to do in the first place. I was just trying to build up suspense. Cough. Which is the best one? We'll grab that one. That's a bronzy. And let's get a breeding pair. I want a young, fertile male. Not for the first time. I've got to stop making those jokes. Any of those particularly fertile? 50% seems to be the best we can do. Let's grab both of those. Right. Any particular ideas about what on earth I'm going to do here? It's not my franchise. I don't really want to spend a billion years making the fanciest thing in the world. But I want to build something cool. I want to grab whatever... Is that staff? Oh, that's a staff path and that's a normal path. I like that a lot. Is this the right type of wood? Looks like it. Yep, let's shorten that. Curl around there. And just join these two together. Oh no, I don't want to do that. I sort of want to do that. I need to think about what the exhibit's going to look like first. Tell you what, let's just build the basic shape and let's go from there. I'm thinking just like a big... I know, it kind of raises up, right? So I kind of want to do like an elevated path. Maybe this can stick, drop down, walk in front of like a glass window here, but then come up a little bit over this river. Yeah, I like that idea. Let's do that. Well, it's going to go that way as well, so let's just keep that like that. And then it's going to split off also over here to the left. We're going to go up and up and up, and that'll do. No staircases. I am a wheelchair-friendly Baird's Tapir exhibit. And we're just going to curve that around up there. I don't think I'm going to make that a loop. You do have to walk all the way back. I know it's a pain, but if you are one of the wheelchair guests, you get a ramp. You get to go meow, which is, you know, fun for the whole family. Okay, cool. Let's get the... It's going to be a fairly huge exhibit. I think this is probably the last exhibit I have to make, so... Yeah, we can just kind of have a little bit... We can go a little crazy with it, is what I'm trying to get out here. Where's my glare set? We're actually going to do the whole thing in glass. This is a top tip recommended by people. Ooh, one-way glass, yeah, for sure. Because glass can be curved, whereas a lot of the other ones can't, if you build your exhibit in the curved material first... Although I hate that it does this. Then... Eh... You can actually replace it later on with a non-curved material and it'll still work. It's really handy. So, like, usually you can't curve the wooden logs, which is what I want to use for the outside. But because we are using the glass first, when we come to finish this exhibit, we'll be able to replace all this with wooden logs and it'll still be curvy. I don't know why it's in the game like that, because clearly the wooden logs can be curved, so why can't we just do it? I don't know, but that is the world we currently live in, so... There we go. Right, let's just try to join those up a little bit better. It's a little bit on the messy side, to say the least. It's also huge, freaking mungus. I'm not really sure what to say about that. It is a giant exhibit. It's half the park, and it's for the tapirs, of all things. I want to do. I don't know. What do we want to do? I want to do a big ass tree in the middle. Maybe like a moat within the exhibit. Oh, buddy. Once they're in, I'm going to... Yeah, we'll pause it just so we can nail their welfare, basically. We do have to get all the animals happy. That's part of our mission, is to get every animal in the park to an acceptable level of happiness. So, I'm going to grab this. We're going to make this a little bit bigger. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just going to... Stick stuff in and hope for the best. Actually, if we attack this with the water tool, what does it look like already? You know what? I quite like that. Like a little island. Oh, and over here we could actually do an underwater viewing area. I don't know why I'd want one for the tapirs, but maybe we do. We don't want to go too wet. You want moderate moistness for a tapir. I think everyone knows that. It's a moderately moist animal. Right, let's get some... Well, let's get the terrain coverage done first. It's perfect, okay. And they should be happy with the water now. It should be tons of the stuff. Come on, buddy. There we go. Yep, more than happy. Right, so we need some hard shelter. And I'm going to stick that in the middle. That can be a centerpiece for our zoo. And we're not going to build it. We should... Species. Baird's tapir. Let's see what we have available. It is African, the shelter, but I think it kind of fits. I say it fits more than that, right? Yeah, let's go for the African one. Why not? I'm going to have that sitting atop. There's a little bit of a hill here. I quite like that. Might soften up this side just a tad. I'm trying to resist going over the top. At the end of the day, this is the campaign, right? In franchise mode, we will still do many over-the-top exhibits, but not in here, not yet. Okay, we have to bring that down a little bit, I think. There we go. Habitat, what else do you need, my friend? Well, we need to give them some bedding, get them nice and cozy. Return of cozy land. Because if you're not cozy, what are you, folks? Beautiful stuff. Right, and what else? Let's give them a ball. Everyone loves a good ball. A fruit spike tree, because I've never seen that before. This exhibit's massive. And a barrel feeder, because why not? I'm also going to give them a food trough. Do I want that to have a little ridge? I don't know. What's the coolest place for that? I actually quite like that. Yeah, why not? And we'll give him a water pipe just in case. Okay, right. Time for some nature. And we can have some fun with this. By the looks of things. There's a lot of... We can go up to 100% coverage. Speaking my kind of language, I swear. So, continent is South and Central America. Biome is tropical, temperate, and grassland. Tropical, temperate, and grassland. Oh, we have lily pads! Awesome! Oh, I've never seen those before. They're adorable. Oh, I really like those. They're at a weird angle because of how the ground is going on. If I get rid of a line to surface, that should stop that, right? Nope, now they've become even worse. Why are they doing that? Well, line to surface is actually an improvement over what the hell they're doing there, so... We just have to put them in and then do a little bit of rotation. That's okay. There's still this little bug every now and again. When you hit X, it doesn't always work. You know, the toggling for some reason. I don't really understand why. Yeah, you know what, that'll do. They're really cool, though. Big fan of those. Never saw those before. What's the biggest one? That one, maybe? That's a big boy. All on his lonesome. Aww. Oh, no. Okay, and let's get a few more over here. There we go. That's what we've been looking for. I like it when they've got a bit of water in them, though. Like, the little one there. That's awesome. Have I said that enough yet? Okay. Ooh. Oh, Panagar. My beloved. Dead now. Killed it. I want this to have a very tropical kind of feel to it. It's got to match up with the rest of the zoo at the end of the day, right? Let's cover this in palms. And then you want to dot a few of these around the exhibit, just so it doesn't look like they're manufactured for that area over there, you know? Okay. Again, but banana palms are pretty cool. Stick a couple of those in. Have a little patch of them over there. And then a big one nearby, kind of like the parents watching over the, you know, the dad's running around after the kids, the mum's chilling in the corner. She's having a drink, she's earned it, she's had a hard day. It's all about telling a story. Oh, foliage is just so good in this game. Some coastal mangrove trees, we'll stick these at the edges. What else have we got? Coconut palm. Yep, really good for this area over here. Oh, beautiful, actually. Absolutely beautiful. going over the top? There's no such thing when it comes to foliage. I think we all know this by now. Cool. It really, foliage saves the day, every time. Some little custard apples. Love myself a custard apple. A custard apple sounds freaking delicious. Can we just point this out? I don't know why it's called a custard apple tree. I'd like to do that research at some point. But it sounds amazing. I mean, this should be enough foliage to keep them happy. What we can do is probably hit play. And then... let's see if they're happy, and we can go from there. We're only looking for 80%, so they are happy enough. I'm not finished. You know, in my heart, I know we're not done. But... what I want is a log. We have to get a log. Oh, some Swiss cheese plants. These are great as well. These are like my favourite plants. Everything is my favourite plant, okay? I get that, but... whatever. I'd like a big tree. Where's the biggest tree? Wimba! Yes! There we go. Good old Wimba. How good does that look? It takes no effort. I miss this game so much. It takes no effort at all and it just looks amazing. And obviously it's very simple, blah 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 blah, but... and we've got bushes! Love a good bush. I'm gonna scratch that last thing. Let's just... oh, and our lobster claws as well. Which look a little different than last time, unless I've gone crazy. Which is a distinct possibility, don't get me wrong. Gathered around the Wimba. Get some hot near. Holly less suits the feeling I'm trying to evoke with my exhibit. I don't know why it required an accent, but it did. Okay. It's looking good. Can we stick some vines on? And have it not look silly? That is the question. Bam. There we go. Nailed it. I can put them. I'm just going to keep that a little bit. That's all I wanted, really. Cough. Nice. Okay, right. Well, we have some very happy BAIRD'S TAPIRs. So we have to go make the other animals happy. We also need to add another animal. Now, it does have, unfortunately, to be a exhibit animal. That's okay. Just going to fill this exhibit in a little bit. And plus, that means we've got more chance of the babies. And I think we all know that the baby BAIRD'S TAPIRs are, like, possibly the cutest animal in the entire game. They're definitely up there. I can have a baby competition. Never mind pageant, beauty pageants for young girls and how problematic that is within society. No, no, no. Now we're having beauty pageants for babies. That's not problematic at all. He's having a little swim. By the lillipids. There we go. Nice and easy. See a tapir. See an iguana. Live the dream. So, animal exhibit trading. Antillean iguana. There we go. What's your name? Esmeralda. That is beautiful, Esmeralda. Beautiful. There you go, my friend. Now, you're not going to be super happy, are you? No. Let's get you super happy. Let's bring that humidity right... yeah, not that far down. Moderately down. I don't know why it doesn't show you the number here. That still seems silly to me. How are you feeling? Esmeralda is feeling good. Serious injured? Oh, right, yeah, because that was one we purchased, and it said we have to nurse her back to health if we're going to get actual CC for releasing her into the wild. You've got to be careful about which animals you buy. It's not just about their genetics and how fertile they are and stuff like that, but a lot of them are injured and in need of care. Right. So, objectives. Have at least 12 species in the zoo. 11. Didn't I add 3? I had 9. I'm confused. Has something died? Let me have a little look here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10. What else am I meant to be adding here? So we need our... let's get our chimps delivered. That should be our 12th species.
My,
there we go.
You have been busy, haven't you? Splendid! But now that you've adopted all these lovely new species, we need to make sure they're nice and happy. So let's get the average welfare across the zoo nice and high, shall we? And by we, I mean you. Go on, get to it.
Looks like we're okay. Good stuff. Yes, we need to make our animals happier. Oh, they, I mean, they're pretty happy, right? They need enrichment. They already have climbable area, apparently, mainly because of the trees. But are you going to jump out? Are you jumping out? I'm watching you, buddy. No, we're okay. We're okay for now. I'm not convinced on that one. Let's get some enrichment for our chimps. I never really thought that that's an interesting combination. Western chimpanzee and Baird's tapir. I don't think that's a normal one, but hey-ho. Bobbin. Let's get a bobbin. Love a good bobbin. And a block of frozen fruit. That's really cool as well. What else do you need? A little bit more toy. A grab ball. Gee, you need a lot, don't you? A picky so-and-so. Block of ice. Ball? Box? Okay, well, they're above 80%. That's what we're looking for. Cool. So, we have our chimps. Oh, they need food. What am I on about? I don't trust the humans, so I'm going to stick those on the ground still. We'll see in the future if I dare to raise those up a little bit. Right, so which animals... Why are you stressing trying to hide? Too many... How can you have too many adults? Right, you're gone as well. That'll sort you out. I'm going to give you a second to realise you do not have the same problem, Mr. Baird's tapir. Look at him! Look at the tree! Don't I only have one tapir? Oh, did I get more? Okay, I'm gonna just... There we go. Okay, are we feeling better now? I'm gonna... Go the injured one. You're both called the same thing. I'm gonna release you as well. Okay, one. No, it should be fine. How are we doing? Still 59%. It's just... I'm kind of blown away by that. Right, you're older. Let's get rid of you. Come on. Oh, no, sorry, Bonobo. Animal is distressed and trying to hide. But why? I mean, you've got one-way glass over here, although it's the wrong way round, apparently. That's maybe contributing slightly. Let's just fix that, not a problem. Plus, it's kind of not great for the guests, if we're honest. Let's get that fixed. Who else is unhappy then? Welfare. All of Red Ruffs have, for reasons beyond my understanding, been boxed up. Where are we? They don't seem... Didn't I just make you all happy? You should be all happy now, right? Yeah, cool. Who else is in dire need of my expert work? The ring-tailed. Okay, let's sort them out. What is wrong with you, lads and lasses? It's always enrichment. Habitat. Swap that over. It should be. I mean, you'd imagine it's generally speaking the same stuff, right? A lemur's a lemur. I'm gonna love lemur stuff. This is one thing I know about lemurs. They like lemur stuff. Look at fruit. There you go.
Lovely job there.
I did it!
You should be proud of yourself.
I am.
Not only have you expanded the zoo and kept the animals as happy as Lanny, but you didn't bankrupt us in the process. Amazing.
Stancy. Right, folks, that is the second mission.
Wow. Ooh. Well, you've certainly transformed the zoo. I barely recognize it. A wonderful new exhibit, some fascinating new species, and you've done wonders for the animals' welfare by enriching their habitats. Who doesn't love playing with a 3-foot-wide soccer ball, huh? I mean, other than professional soccer players. I mean, I'm sure it wasn't easy, though. I expect money was tighter than a possum's pouch. Plowing all those funds back into the welfare of the animals doesn't make running these places a picnic. Although, it does make me feel a little less guilty about how much our gift shops charge. No, as far as I'm concerned, the only reason to run a zoo is to help animal kind. Sadly, it appears some other people have far less noble goals.
Oh no. Something is afoot. Also, tighter than a possum's pouch is like one of the dirtiest things I've ever heard. Like, as soon as he said it, I was like, Bernie, please, Bernie. We don't have that kind of relationship yet, you know? I'm playing around. Aw, my hippos. Right, well, that is the end of our beloved little tropical zoo. What was it called again? Where's the entrance? I love this. I didn't even see this. Imagine you could put like crocodiles in this little bit over here as well. That'd be awesome. What's this? Why does this exist? It's just there for ambiance, I guess. I really like this. This is very cool. It's like multi-layered, and I really like the idea of building a zoo like this surrounded by water in this way and turning them into exhibits. And it's like a little oasis. And yet there's still tons of space left as well. What's the zoo called again? Zoha. It's the Zoha Zoo. Right, yes, thank you for joining me. We will be back tomorrow then with the third campaign mission for the very first time. Really exciting. It's all brand new going forward. Cheers, much love as always. And smash that like. No, I can't do it. If you did enjoy this video, please do consider throwing me a like. It really helps me out and lets me know that you enjoyed the video and gives me better ratings on YouTube, which is good. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way. I'll see you next time.